going to hand it over to the public because we know you love this part of the show. So on the screen, we have got topics for all of our callers this evening. Simon, we're going to start with you. Would you like to do the honours? Who do you want to go for?
Obviously, number one.
Simonopoly. I believe that's Emma. Emma, are you there?
I'm here, Emma.
Hi, Emma. Hi. Thanks for calling in. Emma, who's your question for?
My question is for Simon.
Your question's for Simon.
Hello, Emma.
Yeah. So, Simon, you're the only judge left not to have anyone in the bottom three. So what are you doing night that you're the judge?
Oh, you're going to love this.
Well, you know, it's about spending time with the contestants. Sure. It's thinking more about me rather than them. I don't sing at the start of the show. I think that's really what it is. It's about dedication. It's about respecting your contestants, understanding who they are, listening to them.
Simon, what do you think you're doing different to the other three?
I just said it.
All of those things. He's not singing. He's not singing. I think
I'm not
going to
be singing at the start of Friday night.
That is a shame.
Very good question, Emma. Thank you.
Emma,
thanks for starting around on the panel, babe. Thank you.
Right, Nicole, Simon's had his chance. You have a chance now. Who do you want to go
to? Nicole, can I just say, you look lovely.
Thank you.
You look lovely tonight. You look
gorgeous. I mean, I know I'm no Simon Cowell.
Yeah, true side.
Who is Nicole? Right, let's choose a line. What do you want to go to?
Oh, I like it tit for tat.
Oh,
tit for
tat. It's a bit of Rach.
Yeah, that's Rachel in Wrexham. Hi, Rachel.
Hi, guys.
Oh, she's having a lovely time. Rach, who's your question for?
Simon, Emma was on the phone earlier. Rachel's in.
Simon.
Go for it.
There's been a lot of bad tension between you two lately. What's going on?
Yeah, what's going on with you?
You don't say, Rachel.
I think it's the battle of the divas. It was Divas Week, so.
Si, you got a bit of beef with Nicole?
You know what? I think last night, we all felt that we know these artists now properly. So you're trying to give constructive criticism. And somebody on my RIGHT doesn't like that.
No,
because she only wants people to say yes to her.
Someone's drinking too much Haterade. I'm just trying to be constructive.
Who do you agree with, by the way?
Everybody. And things don't always have to go Simon's way.
Well, they
always
did tonight.
I thought I agree with Nicole.
She agrees with Nicole.
Oh, dear.
She agrees with Nicole. Rachel, thanks for your question, babe.
Even the cardboard cutout of Simon in that looks miffed at that answer.
He's got the right Sharon, let's come to you. You're looking stunning as well. Your ears are a glitter, I tell you, girl. Who would you like to go for, babe?
Gorgeous.
OM Honey G.
OM Honey G. Is that Prez? Is it Prez in Bournemouth? Prez? Hello, Prez. Hello, darling.
Oh, Prez, you look as pale as me.
Yeah, you look well, Prez. Prez, who's your question for, babe?
So, my question is for Sharon.
Go for it.
Husty is through to week four. What does she need to do now to become a credible artist?
Credibility.
Credibility.
Honey G, what does she need to do?
I'm sorry, I didn't hear what was...
So, Honey G's through to week four. What has she got to do now to get the public on side so she feels credible as an artist?
I love her.
She's just relaxing, don't worry
really,
about her.
Just take it easy, take it easy. Listen, I just think you carry on doing what you're doing. You know, some people are great artists and they never get credibility. And you just do what you do.
She's an entertainer, that's what you're saying.
Yeah, exactly what she is. She makes you smile.
She does make you smile. She's been trending worldwide 2 weeks ago for a reason.
Again.
She's
doing something right. Prez, we're going to leave you to enjoy your night.
Your
I think think she's having a lovely time. Yeah, ta-da, Prez.
Don't leave it on too long, Prez. Don't leave it on too long. Yeah. Louis Walsh, look at that board and tell me, what question do you want to answer?
I'm going to go for number three, Band-Aid.
Band-Aid, number three is Lewis in London. Hi, Lewis.
Hi, guys.
Hi, Lewis.
What's your question and who is it for, Lewis?
Okay, so my question is for Louis.
Oh, okay,
Louis. Four of Diamonds were in the bottom two tonight. Why do you think they're not connecting to the public?
Louis. Well, they will. They will. They have a lot of potential. They need more time to grow. I just think they need to work harder, probably.
Hang on, are you not working them hard enough, Louis?
I'm working them hard, but I mean, you know, they've got so much potential.
So you're
these
saying.
Girls.
It's their fault, not your fault.
I'm not saying it's anybody's fault, Simon.
You just said they're going to work harder.
They're going to have to work harder this week.
Because they did.
I don't want them in the bottom two.
Because they did the mashup yesterday. It was two songs.
I know they did, but obviously
it
didn't work.
What do you want, eight songs?
I want them to... I just think they've got so much potential, Sam. And they're such nice girls.
Simon's track record.
I want the public to give them a chance.
Simon's track record, as we know, is flawless so far in this competition. Simon, what should Louis be doing right?
Hang on. Let me just open that can of worms. Here we go.
I said it last night. I really believe with girl bands, they've got to work it out for themselves. You know, if you've got an 80-year-old telling you what songs to sing, it kind of doesn't work.
You said an 80-year-old.
That was a slip of the tongue.
Well, you're the same age as me.
Right.
I think they're brilliant. I think they're going to come back fighting next week.
That is the kind of talk I like to hear.
A bit of fighting spirit.
Let's make some noise, please. Give it up for our judges, everybody.